I believe Indigenous knowledges can have a profound impact on STEM, particularly in areas like environmental management. A lot of these traditions that Indigenous people carried throughout, you know, 60,000 years can really be applied now to the modern day to help solve a lot of the issues that we're facing now. So my name is Punjanam. I'm a Kaurna Naranga. I've been living in Adelaide all my life and currently studying at the University of Adelaide, doing a bachelor's degree in chemical engineering and mathematics and computer science. STEM has impacted my life by giving me a lot of opportunities to work, meet a lot of great people and travel to great places and also be involved with a lot of projects.
YASTA is Young Aboriginal STEM Thinkers of South Australia, and it's the basis of this whole Congress. Developing students' capacity and understanding around STEM and developing students as leaders so that they can learn about Aboriginal connections to STEM and how that relates to them.
Students that are involved in YASTA have amazing opportunities opened up to them through a STEM lens by being exposed to industry and prominent Aboriginal people in the STEM field. It actually gives them an opportunity to see themselves walking that pathway, a legitimate pathway.
By linking Aboriginal traditions and culture and investigating how things have been done in the past and connecting that to the kids' learning makes it very relevant for them. That's probably the key that the kids want to see relevancy.
With our workshop, it's called From Plant to Plate, and we're basically just showing like old ways that Aboriginal people used to like get plants and used to like grind them and just making them into like edible things or into medicine.
One of the things that mainly helped was learning about aquaculture. They actually work within the natural element of nature.
It's an opportunity for students to stand up and make this their own, make these STEM topics their own, and present it to other students.
We sort of noticed a pattern in the earlier years. Aboriginal students performed quite well in STEM-related areas, so your maths and sciences. And then when they sort of hit middle school, that seemed to drop off. We wanted to find some type of avenue for these students to be able to connect to the STEM world.
So I guess the important part culturally for our students is also just coming together. They're coming to a place where they're all quite similar and have similar interests. So just seeing their connection and their confidence build throughout, you know, them days is really something special to watch.
This bit, the binary code, it was designed by me and I'm glad it made it, but if you translate it, it spells out Aboriginal.
The Congress definitely opens up a lot of them conversations, like, okay, this is a path I sort of had in mind, but after attending the Congress, they're thinking of other avenues and not restricted to one career path. So I think it's, you know, anything's possible.
When I grow up, I kind of want to become like a forensic scientist, and that uses a lot of STEM for it, and I'd never really wanted to be there until I started getting into STEM.
What excites me about my future is being able to have the opportunity to do STEM, not just like regular jobs like working at fast food restaurants, like actually making chemicals and exploring all the different sides of STEM.
When I'm older, I think just helping like inspire kids to do what they feel like and just to know that they can do it and that there's other people out there that are doing it. Now is the time in our program where you will be listening to a Spotlight on STEM presenter.
Aboriginal learners might want to go work in the mining industry. Often Aboriginal people are asked to be cultural consultants, but we want our Aboriginal learners to be engineers, you know, in these mining companies or have the choice or do both.
So what I hope the students and the teachers as well can bring back from this Congress to the classroom is that an understanding that STEM and Indigenous knowledges aren't these two separate worlds and they in fact exist together.
Whether it's STEM related or Aboriginal related or not, at the end of the day, these students have grown into these amazing leaders and they actually believe that self-worth and confidence, which is all you want for your students really anyway, to be successful.